Hey guys, welcome to today's video. Do you like my neon nails? I am Joyita. In this video, I'm going to show you an affordable way of cleaning your makeup brushes without spending a ton on buying expensive makeup brush cleaning solutions, which are basically soapy water itself. I'm going to show you how to use all the things which are there in your house already to clean your brushes, because these are tools that you directly use on your face. So keeping them hygienic is a good way to steer clear of breakouts and skin irritations. So the things you'll be needing is a mild shampoo or a cleanser or a soap or a hand wash. I'll be using a hand wash. Secondly, you need a cleaning pad. So you can buy an extra like this, which costs around 200 to 300 rupees. Or you can buy a bigger cleaning pad, or you can just use your palms. Apart from this, you would need a newspaper to keep your brushes on, because you don't want to wet your desk or anywhere else, because water would be dripping from the brushes. And you can use a conditioner, which again is okay for your skin. This will hydrate the brushes, and it's going to be easy for you to use makeup and blend it on your skin. It kind of makes the brushes really soft. The last and the most important thing you need is running water. So I would suggest you do it on your sink, or you can also do it in a tub, but obviously a sink is better, because it's going to just clean off the dirty brushes in seconds. Firstly, I'm going to show you how to clean a makeup sponge, which you use daily to blend out your foundation. First, you need to soak your sponge in water and hold it under water till it has reached its maximum size, so it's nice and fluffy. Then apply soap on all the areas you can see the makeup on. Gently rub it with your fingers so it loosens the makeup, and then you're going to hold it under the water and rinse the makeup out. Keep cleaning it and keep rinsing it till your makeup sponge is completely squeaky clean. Always wash your sponge after every use. That is the most hygienic thing to do, because if you don't clean your sponge every time, it might grow bacteria, and you directly apply it on your skin, right? So clean it after every time, or if you can't, just at least do it after the second use. So next we go into cleaning makeup brushes. If you do have an eggshell or a makeup cleaning pad like I do, all you need to do is wet your brush, apply soap, whatever you have, on the brush. Just keep on swirling it around the silicone texture so the makeup breaks down and it kind of leaves your brush and says goodbye. If you have like a very tiny brush that you need to clean, like lip liner or eyeliner brushes, which have very tiny bristles, you need to go into the tiny groove part, which is made in the eggshell. Other than that, you can clean all the fat bristle brushes in the other end. So if you do not want to invest in an eggshell, you can also use your palm, which will create a friction and which will also help you clean out the makeup very easily. If you take care of your brushes, it will definitely last you longer. And do not be lazy like I am. I really, really, really hate cleaning brushes because it almost feels like a chore. I love doing makeup and taking pictures and all of those things, but this is one of the chores that I hate doing. But if you want to keep your skin clean and breakout free, and you want to maintain that hygiene level, I would advise you to at least go and clean all your brushes once a week. If you do not, you know, use your brushes that often, do it at least after 4 to 5 uses of the brush. 5 things you shouldn't do. These are five things that you should not do. You would want to keep this on your mind before you're cleaning your brushes. Firstly, do not use hot water for your brushes because this will melt the glue in the brush. The bristles will come out. You don't want to keep the brushes in an upright position. Even if you use cold water, water over time will dissolve glue and it's again going to loosen your brushes. You should always keep the brushes in a downright position. Do not use any vegetable oil on your brushes. I actually went and watched a video which said use olive oil on your makeup sponge. When I did that, I had a ton of fungi grow on it. So I would suggest do not do that because insects and bacteria are going to attack your brushes because of the vegetable oil in it. And if you have pets around, keep your brushes in a safe space away from your beautiful fur babies because they might attack them. And one more thing, do not dry your brushes in the sun. Again, it can melt the glue and it will destroy the brushes. Keep it in a cold, dry area. So this concludes my video. Thank you for watching. I'm gonna post videos twice a week from now. Hopefully I'm gonna keep up to my schedule. So turn on the notification bell if you don't want to miss a post. And see you guys in the next video. Bye.